today, in fact, like every month, CNBC TV 18 in association with the National Stock Exchange celebrate Prosperity Day, a day where we seek to inform and educate investors about smart investing practices, thus enabling the journey to wealth creation. S. Naren, ED and CIO of ICICI Prudential AMC, joins us now. Hi, Mr. Naren. Thanks so much for joining in, and compliments of the season from all of us here at CNBC TV 18. How are you viewing trade setup? I mean, it's Christmas, but everyone's so negative as of now. What's your view? A perfect time to start chipping in?
See, let me wish all the viewers a very happy Christmas and a year ahead. See, we come from the mutual fund fraternity, and you know, if you look at the start of the year, small and mid caps were extremely overvalued, and globally markets were on a roll. So actually, as the year ended, we have a situation where market valuations have corrected. I mean, even on a big, large developed market like US, you've seen a massive correction in the last 2 months, and that has made markets much more reasonably valued in most places. And from an investor's point of view, this kind of an environment is clearly superior to what we saw at the start of the year, because today for us, barring about a handful of stocks in large cap, mid cap and small cap, most of the market is more reasonably valued, and therefore there are interesting opportunities for us to look at investing. So I would actually view the correction as healthy, because if you have an overvalued market and you're a long-only mutual fund, you had more problems at the start of the year than you have at this point of the time.
Oh, that's extremely well put, Naren. Thank you very much indeed for joining us on what's a special day. It's also, we're also calling it Prosperity Day. It may rankle a bit when you see red on the screen, but that's the time to buy, as you said. I want to speak about your new fund offer, your opportunities fund. But before that, give us a little bit of perspective. You know, the global commentary that we read is extremely gloomy. Like we were discussing earlier in the morning, NASDAQ has entered into bear terrain last Friday. S&P entered into bear terrain on Monday. The DAX and the Hang Seng indices are already in bear terrain. Crude is down 45% on growth scares. I mean, in this context, can we brave it? Can we be the lone man standing?
See, I think if you're talking about the near term, clearly the outlook is slightly worrying, given that India has drastically outperformed all the global markets over the last few months. But if I look at opportunities to invest, I think there it's a different situation. I think, from Diwali onwards, we have been actually supporting SIPs. We actually recommend 2019 as an SIP year, because what is difficult in the near term and what is a good SIP period for prosperity, as you put it, it's clearly a superb period for SIPs from the point of view of long-term prosperity. If you do SIPs when the markets are overvalued, it may not be as good as it is today. So I would say this 2019 is SIP year, and it supports your entire prosperity initiative. So that's how we look at it. So frankly, we are not worried about near-term trends. We think that near-term the markets will be volatile. We think the whole of 2019 could be volatile, mm-hmm. due to both local and global reasons. But there are huge opportunities in that volatility. Mm-hmm. I don't think there are huge opportunities in periods like January 2018.
All right, Naren, tell us, you know, different situations offer different opportunities. So tell us about your NFO, the Special Situations Opportunity Fund that you're launching.
See, actually, we were looking at global categories which have performed very well over a long-term period of time. And we found that Special Situation was one interesting category where globally people have actually been very, very have good long-term experiences. And the reason for special situations doing well in the long term is very interesting, because periodically you do have periods of time when you have strikes, you have big quality problems, you have company specific events, you have sector specific events. And a special situation kind of a mandate allows you to buy cheap, because at that point of time, it is due to that problem that these stocks become cheap. And therefore, you know, you get to buy cheap. And secondly, with a big active mutual fund industry, what happens is very easy to accumulate, because many of the active mutual fund investors are either growth or quality. And therefore, they, when there is see a problem, they actually run away from it. And this kind of strategy, which is a special situation strategy, gives you the opportunity to buy when everyone is running away, which is part of good global investment theory. And we saw an opportunity to look at this category, and we have launched the ICICI Prudential India Opportunities Fund to capitalize on special situations. What are the risks in the category? The risks are that near-term performance will be volatile. And because it is not a benchmark fund, it's a category where you will pick what has a problem, and you may not have those steady stocks where there is no problem. So I believe that this is a volatile fund in the near term with good long-term potential for investors. And I think as the industry becomes bigger, we need to have such strategies, because these strategies are more interesting for the long term.
Yes, I guess the rate at which other markets have moved into, you know, ETFs with mutual funds not really outperforming, I think India will have to get more sophisticated. Though here, I guess mutual funds still have a bit of an edge. Naren, if you can demonstrate with an example, I mean, do you mean that at such a time you should be buying NBFCs in a fund like this? Is that what you mean when you say, you know, you catch them when they are stressed?
Actually, you asked the right thing. Sometimes you can choose to buy another sector which has actually benefited. So if you look at, for example, when PSU banks went through a big NPL problem, you could have bought both NBFCs and private banks, and they actually delivered very good experience. In the recent NBFC issue, clearly the opportunity, the profits, the margins of the corporate banks improved significantly. So I think with an opportunity like corporate banks, actually like NBFC, actually you would buy corporate banks rather than buy NBFCs. But there are times when you actually could buy the sector in trouble. Like if you look at 2015, when the China problem became intense and people felt that China is going to blow up. At that point of time, metal stocks had reached a very, very interesting level, that a pharma stock was higher than the market cap of the entire metal sector. At that point of time, we could buy metals, but I would say there are times when you buy the beneficiaries, there are times when you buy the sector which is affected, and both would be special situations in the way we would look at. And it's not as if you buy everything which is fallen. And one of the global experiences of special situation has been that in leveraged stocks, you have to be very careful in special situations.
Okay.
The reason is in leveraged stocks, if you go buy a special situation, the company can go bankrupt. And that's why I would say that the experience globally from special situation investing has been that you have to be careful in leveraged stocks. But in all other stocks, you get very good investment opportunities. Let's say when there's a big quality problem on there, whether there's a big competitive war between all the players in a sector, etc.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, actually, at the moment, it looks like the market itself is in a special situation stress. I mean, it's the mid-cap index is now down 1.6%. That's 277.78 down in terms of points. And the advanced declines have gone to 5 in the red for 1 in the green. So that's 80% of the market lower than where it was on Monday. And actually, Monday itself, we were sitting on 3 days of losses.
Right.
So it's not looking like a very easy market at this point in time. It's taking the global growth negativity into play, and we are seeing more and more people abandoning, perhaps taking profit before the year runs out. Naren, where do you find support? Do you think that earlier support of 10,300 will work? Because we also have positives from this situation because of crude.
See, actually, if you look at Indian markets in 2018, just like you had a FANG set of stocks in US, in India also, you have a set of stocks which have done extremely well in 2018. which are very costly relative to the market. So, you know, it's difficult to predict what happens to the large cap index, because the large cap index has high weightages in some of these stocks. But I think when I look at from a stock picking hat at this point of time, I find different interesting opportunities of stocks with good dividend yields trading at very, very reasonable valuations. And the advantage is that you can look at only the cheap stocks and the stocks with which have become extremely cheap, rather than focus on the index. If you look at the Indian large cap index, it is not yet dirt cheap. Mm. But there are opportunities within the index which have become very, very cheap.
Well, Naren, you know, some of those FANG stocks are down between 35 to 40%. I think Facebook is down nearly 45% from the recent peak. And out here, at least some of the stocks and some of the high-quality stocks haven't corrected much. But the good point today, at least in trade, is the Nifty is struggling, but the Indian rupee has shown some strength. And the IT stocks are struggling. You know, various funds of yours, you all do have some exposure out there. How do you all view the IT space going ahead? Because some of these stocks are the biggest losers today as well.
See, our view on IT has been that it's a sector which is attractive, but, you know, given the sizes of the companies, it's not easy for them to grow. And we think that, you know, with the correction, there is an opportunity. But if you look at some of the IT services companies listed in NASDAQ, they have fallen like much more sharply than what you see in India. So I think one can be positive on them, but you'll have to pick them up as they fall, because the way the NASDAQ has seen a correction in the last 2 months is simply astounding. So, you know, you have IT services stocks listed in NASDAQ, which are much cheaper than the Indian IT services players. So I would say that one is positive, because I think if you look at it, India has certain areas of strength. And IT services is certainly one of them. And so I think the long-term view looks good, but you have to buy more selectively and more carefully.
Okay. Well, that's useful advice, especially at a time like this. You know, for the past, I think, at least two, three weeks, the fashion has been CapEx stocks and maybe even commodity stocks, because, you know, we haven't invested in power and steel for a long time. So the theme has also been to look at these infrastructure stocks. What would your take be? The L&T variety of CapEx stocks and, you know, the steel and power variety of, say, BHEL has seen a goodish bit of buying. Do you think this is a theme that will play out in 2019?
So I think it will play out in the next 3 to 5 years. And I think clearly with oil falling, we became clearly positive on infrastructure as a theme. Because what we have noticed is whenever oil goes up, tech and pharma tend to do well. And that is not a component in any infrastructure play. So I think at this point of time, given that oil has fallen, I think the next 3 to 5 years look good. Interesting is that last 10 years, there have been no returns. And I've seen as an investment theory, if you have sectors or themes which haven't worked for 10 years, you buy them, you actually get their good returns over the next 3 to 5 years. The fact is that, you know, because of the bankruptcy code and some of the resolutions, what happens is some of the capex in sectors and steel and power can get delayed, because people will do debottlenecking and make use of the existing capacity more usefully. And that will be very positive for the economy, but won't be very positive for the near-term capex. So that's why I think with the capacity utilization increasing, with the bankruptcy code resolutions happening, I think the next 3 to 5 years look good. Are they going to have a big super cycle in 2019? I don't think so. Because, but I think over the next 5 years, infrastructure and capex is a theme to play.
Okay. Well, there's some news coming in that Bank of Baroda is taking shareholder nod for issuing 10 crore shares to employees. It'll be very good if we can see more ESOP issuances, so that the rather, you know, disappointed and demoralized set of public sector bankers get a spring in the step. But a final question to you, what about consumption? It's a theme that's always helped us. It's some of our best stocks of the last 20 years would be an Asian Paints, would be, you know, stocks that support consumption like Bajaj Finance. Now, the Marutis of the world are not having a very good time. What's your sense? Do you think it can lie low for a bit? The Marutis, the two-wheeler stocks, basically discretionary consumption.
See, basically, the near term, the sector has still done well over the last 5 years. So I think the near term outlook is slightly confusing. But if I look at one structural theme over the next 10, 20, 30 years in global markets, it's clearly consumption. And that's one of the reasons, you know, if you look at any consumer play, many of these MNCs have bought strategic stakes in Indian consumer plays. Because I think there are few structural themes in the world for the next 10, 20, 30 years. They're less prone to disruption. So I think from a long-term structural play, they're very good. Are they cheap yet? Many of them are still not cheap. Many of the consumer stocks are still expensive. We have been thinking that they've been expensive over the last 2 years, but they've further gone up. But I still think the near-term outlook is a bit confusing. But it's one of the best structural plays for the next 10, 20 years.
All right. Naren, it's always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you very much for joining in the last week.
Wishing you all of you a happy new year.
Thank you. And same to everybody at home and in ICICI Pru as well.